She is one of our African community members. Today we'll be talking about hashtag African gangs. Hashtag African gang is circulating on social media currently on Facebook, Twitter, and Snapchat. I've seen a couple of photos on Snapchat and also on Instagram. This hashtag was as a result of some of the responses that we saw on the media last week in regards to the crimes that are being committed by the young African youth in Melbourne, and the responses that we got from our politicians, the Minister for Immigration and Border Protection, Mr. Doughton, and our Australian Prime Minister, Mr. Turnbull, warning the Victorian Premier, Daniel Andrews, of failing to address the growing gang violence and lawlessness of African-born offenders. The Minister for Immigration and Border Protection also said that people are scared to go out at night because they are followed home by these gangs. So, Achol, I've seen that you posted some of these photos on Facebook with your young ones, your families, saying hashtag African gangs. So what is hashtag African gangs all about?
Thank you, Apook. My name is Achol, as you heard from Apook. I am actually one of the active members in the community of South Sudanese. At the moment, I am a Secretary General in the Office of South Sudanese. And what is happening with this hashtag African gangs is just us as a community trying to raise awareness to white Australians that we are not what has been painted on the media by media coverage, because yes, we do acknowledge that we have troubled teens, but they are not gangsters. So that's why we as a community has involved taking pictures of us doing what any other Australian society would do, and just trying to make it clear that we are not who being portrayed.
Absolutely. That's really a great initiative. And I was quite surprised yesterday when I saw a lot of photos on Facebook of people sharing their photos on doing their normal daily things about just being an Australian. I thought that was really great. Based on the comment that our Prime Minister said, African-born offenders, I'm quite sure that some of these teenagers were born here in Australia, and for him to eliminate them or to outcast them by calling them Australians, it makes me wonder, as a mother, how do you feel about, you know, your children that were born in Australia? How do you feel about them being referred to as African-born instead of being considered Australian-born citizens?
I do actually feel very disappointed for the simple fact that my kids are being alienated into an environment where they were born and raised. Those kids are not gangsters. They are just normal teenagers that are doing their own daily things. We, as a South Sudanese community, has actually assimilated well into Australian way of life. Yes, we do have highly educated people. We have people that work, taxpayers. We are actually contributing positively into Australia. And we do appreciate the fact that Australia has given us a second chance. And we are here to make it more safer and better for everyone else. Now, do not forget that we actually acknowledge we have troubled teens, but we also need to look at them as a normal teenager running around, just need some help and guidance.
Absolutely, I do agree with you, Achol, and I hope that our Prime Minister would see it that way, or the Minister for Immigration and Border Protection, that these kids are just, they're troubled kids, they need our support, they're probably disengaged from school, or they're coming from families that are broken down, or they're affected by drugs and alcohol, which is happening across Australia, regardless of race. So for our Prime Minister to refer to our children as gangsters and thugs, I thought that was a bit off, because as you've mentioned, we are contributing positively to the Australian society, and we want Australia to be safe, and we do not condone violence, we do not condone crimes, we are not supporting those young ones to go out there terrorizing people, because safety is very important. Absolutely. So safety is very important. What message are you sending out there to the people of the world, or to white Australians that are currently scared because of the gangs that are terrorising everyone, Australian-born gangs that are terrorising everyone in Melbourne currently, what message do you have through the African gang hashtag?
Well, my message to white Australians is an African gang could be me and my kids playing in the park, going to the restaurants, on the transportation platform, and I would like not to be viewed as a gangster rather than any other Australian society, any other Australians. So my message is very simple. We, as a South Sudanese, and I quote, African gangs, are actually here to make sure that we have a safe and sound environment. Me being painted as a gangster is putting me at risk in the society. I could be seen as a threat when I am doing my own thing during the day. So we are just a community that raising kids, working hard, assimilated well in Australian way of life, and we are not gangsters.
Absolutely, I agree with you, Chol, because a lot of us have integrated, and you've seen the photos from African hashtag of graduates, of people that are working, and so I hope we will not be seen as gangsters, and as that's as the media puts it, because I feel like a lot of stories are overly exaggerated, and it's causing, we're losing our reputation.
Absolutely.
And a lot of, it's having a lot of impact on us as well as the community, so I'm glad that the African communities have taken the initiative to fight back, and hopefully, I hope something will change. What do you think? Do you believe this will change something, the African gang hashtag?
I am not sure this will change anything, but I do hope it should change the perceptions of how we are being viewed at the moment. Mm. We are actually doing so well. Some of us are doing really good, and those kids are also trying to flip their life around. So we need now as a community, as Australian society, to come up with preventative ways of trying to control what is happening right now with the youth.
I wouldn't really call them gangs. You know why? They do not have a leader. They are not organized. These are just a group of friends that are going out there, obviously committing crimes. And where do these people belong? In the hands of the law. So for the media to go out there and call African gangsters or our children gangsters, teenagers that are trouble, media better be a bit more careful because they are really, really having a lot of impact on us negatively.
And this is where the media really need to be very careful because we, the way in our own cultural setting norms, we like to stay in a group. So if one or two, three young people are found playing together, talking together, they should not be seen as a gangsters. And I'll just make an example. A couple of days ago, just before this hashtag has been circulating, there was a mother that was in a restaurant in McDonald's, just having a normal family setting, trying to grab some bite. The police just came and confront the family, saying, we have seen that you are actually causing threat into the people, when they were just a normal teen, just having their dinner with their own mother. That should not be encourage, and this is where the media really need to see what is happening. We shouldn't be used as a shield or as a way of trying to achieve whatever the hidden agenda is.
Absolutely, because it's going to be more provocative, because if you see a lot of young people together, I believe some people would feel threatened because the media is saying these are gangs. So when we are seen in groups, perhaps we will be deemed as troublemakers or as gangsters or thugs, but that's not reality. So African hashtag hopefully will send out a message to the wider Australian communities that we are not thugs and we are not gangsters. Thank you very much, Chol, for having you. It was great. Keep up the great work of the African hashtag.
It's my pleasure and honor to be here today. Thank you very much. And to my fellow Australian, let's please be part of the solution. Let's not try to fuel up things that should not then be benefiting to us. Because not only are you putting the community at risk, especially now this goes to the media people, you are actually painting a wrong perception on people's mind. We are not who you think we are. And yes, we do acknowledge we have troubled teens and would like to come up with a solution to make sure these kind of things are not going on. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Please do not forget to share our page and like African Australia Discoveries. Until next time, thank you very much.
Thank you.